Namaskar, Munchers. My name is Harsh.
And I'm Shreyas.
And we're back again with part 2 of
Marvel Phase 4 announcements, baby.
From San Diego Comic Con.
All Edge.
Welcome back to Munch on This, guys.
Yep. And we had to do part 2 because we just went overboard,
There's
guys.
There's so much to talk about here.
So, yeah, let's carry on from where we left off in part
Absolutely.
1 coming up right now. And now we're back to more series.
Disney Plus, dude, like, it's gonna get flooded and people are they've clearly given people an initiative to get onto Disney Plus already.
Totally.
What's happening next?
So this is Loki and this picks up from Endgame where
In an alternate dimension, Loki gets a Tesseract and he vanishes. In our reality, he's died, obviously. Yeah. Thanos killed him, right?
Right.
But we've all seen that scene in Endgame where he gets a Tesseract and vanishes.
Right.
He does some mischievous things in that universe, in that reality, and this TV series is going to be set on that.
Yep.
So Tom Hiddleston's back.
Yes.
Who does not love this guy, Potter?
Absolutely, man. It's funny how Tom Hiddleston actually went to audition for Thor.
Thor, yeah.
And they're like, wait a second, we actually like you as Loki better. And he's like, fine, I'll
and
do it.
And he's killed. Before Thanos came in, he was my favorite villain for the MCU.
Absolutely.
For Marvel. He was so, you know, every time he was charming,
yes.
He was mischievous, he was the bad boy who you latch on to. Exactly. So I loved Loki and I'm
Absolutely.
Really glad we're getting more of him.
Yes, totally. And again, like he said, this starts from an alternate dimension, which they messed up, which now brings us to the What If series. And we had no idea what this was. This is again on Disney Plus. It's gonna be an animated series.
Yeah. With all original casts and voice actors coming back.
This is gonna be crazy. So basically what If is basically different realities. For example, we have like about 13-14 volumes of comics where, for example, if Iron Man did not create Ultron, what would happen?
Yeah.
If Thor if Thor went for
the zombie universe is a what if.
Yeah.
So Marvel zombies, I'm pretty sure that's gonna happen one day or the other now, and I'm really glad.
Yeah, so basically Kevin Feige said that we've come to 23 movies and we've come up with a lot of important plot points, obviously, and a lot of movies tie into each other, and eventually we reach the Infinity Saga. So they're gonna deal with that and they're gonna say that, if this thing happened, what would happen in an alternate
reality? Repercussions of some actions done differently.
Right.
With all voice actors coming back as themselves.
But an animated series. So this is just like the best of both worlds.
You know me, I'm a huge fan of anime and animation in itself.
Right.
So I can't wait for this once again. Marvel is doing so many different things this time.
Totally.
So Phase 4 just consists of so many different things. It's not just movies now.
Yep.
They're spreading their legs and hands everywhere.
Right.
Which is kick-ass of all to do.
Right. And now moving on. Continuing on Disney Plus, middle of 2021, we've got Hawkeye.
And who is he training?
He's training a certain Kate Bishop.
Who's gonna be a better Hawkeye than Hawkeye
him.
One day, yeah?
Right.
So this is basically him showing her the ropes, training her.
Yeah.
This is gonna be a season. I'm guessing there's gonna be more seasons than one, maybe.
Yeah.
But so I'm really looking forward to this because Jeremy Renner, I really like the guy.
Same
as an actor, as Hawkeye.
Same
I think in Endgame he was a badass.
Oh my god, his hairstyle and the tattoo, bro, the arm sleeve. Holy shit.
Like the way he just killed off one of the
Ronin.
Outriders, yeah. You're just going through them like knife through butter. Mad.
Yeah, so this is going to be really cool and this is basically Hawkeye 2.0.
Absolutely, yeah.
So looking forward to...
And someone to take up the mantle. Right?
Yeah, the new Hawkeye.
Maybe Young Justice coming up soon.
Whoa. And now finally we come to the biggest blockbuster, arguably. This is the only movie that has a fourth movie. This is Thor, Love and Thunder.
Yeah.
Holy shit, Taika Waititi is back to direct.
Yes.
Natalie Portman's back.
Tessa Thompson's
back. Thor's back. Christian Hemsworth. So,
but there's something else happening here. What's happening?
Right, we might have a new Thor.
Yeah.
Or a sidey Thor, whatever you want to call it.
Natalie Portman.
Wielding Mjolnir.
Yeah, and she's playing female Thor, which is again straight from the comics.
Yep.
This happens in the comics. Thor goes away and Jane Foster becomes Thor.
Nice.
So I can't wait for this. I can't wait to see Love and Thunder.
Yeah.
This is what Taika Waititi, when he came onto the panel, he's like, there's nothing more stronger than love.
Yeah.
But Love and Thunder together,
next level.
Ass. So yeah, I'm really looking forward to this. This entire movie, even the logo in itself, just has that very 80s vibe.
Yeah, it's so comic book. Exactly. I love it.
I'm guessing it just carries exactly on from Ragnarok.
Yeah.
And I can't, again, the entire pair of, you know, the team of these guys, I can't wait to see them again, man.
Totally. And yeah, those are all the dates we have for you. This is again 2021.
And this is phase 4.
This is phase 4. Right. We have a few announcements where there are no dates, so it's possibly phase 5.
Huge announcements, maybe.
Right. A certain Mahershala Ali as...
two-time Academy winner.
Yeah, as freaking Blade.
Dude.
Jesus.
God. Alright, so I just finished watching Alita Battle Angel again.
Yeah.
You see Mahershala Ali in the movie.
Yes.
He's wearing those shades.
Yeah,
and the
first
thing I came on, I was like, he would be a kick-ass Blade.
Nice.
And then Kevin Feige goes up and does this on stage and I'm like, oh my God.
Sweet.
I'm in his mind, or he's in my mind, or something like that is happening. Like, it's mad, but...
Yeah. Yeah, this is really, really cool. In fact, a lot of people think that Marvel started out with Spider-Man and stuff like that. In fact, Wesley Snipes played...
For the first one? First Marvel character?
Yeah, he played Blade. Yeah, all the way back in the 90s, man. So, and he was pretty cool. I personally enjoyed those movies.
And also, I heard a rumor. I don't know if this is true per se, but I heard a rumor that Wesley Snipes is going to be in this movie.
Oh, damn.
And he's going to show... Marshall Ali the ropes or something like that. Ooh. That's what is happening.
Like,
I'm not too sure what. This is just a rumor.
It's not confirmed.
Something that I've heard.
Yeah.
So I can't wait to see where this goes, man. And apart from that,
we've got
certain individuals, a group of four coming back to Marvel.
Fantastic Four, baby.
Yeah.
Holy shit. I mean,
after ages.
Yeah.
The gods have heard our prayers.
Absolutely. I mean, I remember the first go, it was okay.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah, the cast was decent. Doing his thing, being an arrogant four. And then the second version was so bad.
Oh my God.
I mean,
what did they do with Doctor Doom then?
Oh my God, what did they do with all of them?
And to think of the actors that they had on board for that movie. All the actors were phenomenal.
Yeah. And yeah, that was such a shit show.
Exactly.
It's not even funny.
Ended up butchering the entire movie.
Yeah.
Oof.
So I hope they're gonna do this in a much better way.
Knowing MCU,
yep.
I don't think I couldn't trust anybody else more than you know, Kevin Feige to do them justice.
Yes.
After they've been butchered so badly so many times. The third iteration, I'm pretty sure they're gonna nail it.
Right. And they also mentioned mutants.
Not X-Men particularly. What does that lead us into?
I have no freaking idea. We've had like some 13 or 12 movie, 12 X-Men. No way so far. We were expecting a 13th, maybe this year or next year. Yeah. But that puts an end to Fox's
whole X-Men run.
Bullshit randomness that they've done with X-Men. So yeah, so again, we don't know exactly what's going to happen.
Yeah.
They're definitely going to do something new because there's so many mutants. And they're big names that they haven't even touched upon. Like Gambit was such a shit show in the movie.
Blob doing an origin.
Exactly. So yeah, we hope
all of them,
this is going to turn out to be well. A few movies that we know are in the works but are not particularly mentioned. We've got Guardians of the Galaxy 3.
You've got Black Panther.
Exactly. And we've got Captain Marvel 2. And we've got Captain Marvel 2.
Yeah, obviously.
So, yeah, so, I mean...
I'm guessing this is going to be Phase 5 because Phase 4 is just limited to...
Correct.
That's where it ends.
Exactly.
They've already said there's not going to be too long. They're going to keep it short to just 2 years.
Yep.
And from then, Phase 5, they've already planned out Phase 5 already.
Correct.
And they've got the crossovers already planned out.
Yes.
So again, Marvel, man.
Yeah, doing their thing. Yeah.
And Feige.
And all of this is interlinked. Like you said, crossovers are already planned. And it's going to be really funny to see, I mean, interesting to see what Marvel does with this because they've had their hurrahs, they've made their money.
Endgame was their big hurrah, man.
Exactly.
They've toppled
Avatar.
Sweet. They've toppled Avatar. This is the highest grossing movie ever.
So, does that mean they've crossed the 3 billion mark?
No, it's 2.78.
Oh, so
they crossed that. Yeah.
So, let's hope they make 3 billion. I don't know. Whatever, Blu-ray sales? Yeah. Does that count?
Skynet taking over the world, clearly. Sarah Connor, we need you.
We haven't got any major characters. These are all side characters, guys, part of the Avengers.
Yeah.
They've had movies in their own rights and they've had solo movies. So this is going to be interesting to see how Marvel sort of moves on from post Tony Stark.
The Godfathers are gone.
Yeah.
Chris Evans gone.
Steve
Tony
Rogers
Stark's
gone. Exactly.
So how they move on from these characters.
Yeah.
But obviously they already have such a big ensemble of characters and actors.
And
I'm pretty sure they can pull something off really, really well.
I'm hoping to. I mean, they've got a lot of stuff right. right, and they were testing and trialing a lot of different things, and obviously what we see is pure success, what we see is pure blockbuster level stuff across Marvel phases 1, 2 and 3. This is something really new, this is different. We've got series, we've got a streaming channel, we've got a couple of reboots.
We've got animation being a part of this
universe. Absolutely, yeah, with the same voice actor.
Exactly.
So we might have RDJ voicing Tony Stark.
Again, in an animation form.
Exactly.
Kick ass to see.
Yeah, that's going to be really cool. We might have Paul Bettany come back and voice Jarvis.
So
really cool stuff.
Absolutely.
Keep an eye, 2019.
Also, another movie that we're kind of forgetting maybe.
Which is?
Spider-Man, dude. Sinister Six, that's definitely happening.
Yeah.
So maybe not Sinister Six, but they've teased them enough.
Exactly.
I'm pretty sure Mysterio, once you have Mysterio in the play, the next step is Norman Osborn, and he generally goes up and rounds off the Sinister Six.
Yes.
So I'm pretty sure we already know the third Spider-Man is happening.
And everyone knows who Spider-Man is.
Oh, everybody knows who Spider-Man is now.
So
spoilers.
So not just Sinister Six. Yeah, there's going to be Sinister 600 possibly.
It's going to be insane.
So
can't wait for this.
So way too much of stuff, which is why this video is so freaking long, but we can go on and on and on. And yeah, stay tuned. I think we're going to keep in touch with a lot of the updates. Yeah, keep track of them.
We're doing a little more stuff from SDCC, because obviously it's one of the biggest events for geeks like us, man.
Yeah, and we had to do a Marvel exclusive.
Obviously, yeah.
Hall H.
Demands it.
Yeah, and yeah, some really cool stuff that the Hall H guys got to see that we haven't seen, but we've heard about.
I'm hoping stuff will be released soon.
Eventually.
Eventually, but yeah, a lot of...
Yep.
If a lot of it is exclusive to Hall H, so
cool.
Next time maybe.
That about wraps it up. That was non-stop. Like I said, we can't stop. But
yeah, the hype train, man. For Marvel, let's go.
Let's go. Cool, man. Thank you so much for catching us once again. This is Harsh and Shreyas. Munch on this.
Signing off, guys.
See you soon.
Like, share, subscribe as usual. Be back for more.